Singles lockdown to the queen. Queen's working through here. Oh my goodness, there's so much going on. Jump spells down. FCC lower bracket semifinals. We got Chasmac versus Clash Champs. The winner of this will play Tribe Gaming, and the winner of that match will go on to play the Queen Walkers in the finals. Chasmac starting us off. We got Van coming in, and we got a Queen Walk Lalo here. Starting up top here, gonna send the blimp in early, trying to get that monolith. We were just talking about how the monolith is seeing a nerf, and this is how you plan for the monolith, just try to get it out early. We had a rocket loon in there with a couple yetis, no rage spell going down. Gonna hope the yeti mites can pop over this wall and get down, but it does not. The monolith stays up. That is a huge miss there for Van. Queen is already under a lot of pressure from this king. Wallbreaker's coming in here. Wallbreaker falls short also from the monolith that stayed up. Queen's under pressure from the monolith. Queen's going outside now. This is going sideways. Queen is down! Queen is down early. This is not the start Chasmac was looking for. Van under heavy pressure. This is an anti-2 base with that queen getting next to no value. The CC getting next to no value. This is going to be a tough sweep through for Van to bring this one back. King will come in, start trying to cut off some of these defenses to push that Lalo through, but it's a really small Lalo, guys. We only have one Lava Hound and 17 balloons. This is going to be a very tough save on this base. And we see those monoliths, man, right through the queen's ability. Just popped her. The ability went off, and then the monolith finished her off right through ability. Crazy stuff. That blimp got next to nothing. Royal champions over here on the right side. King's just trying to get as much pathing, but we're going to have the queen and the royal champion along with the double poison tower in the middle of this base, which is going to make it very, very tough. Diggy's over there with the royal champion. The king has the phoenix helping out. Pulls out a Titan with the Ice Golem right here, which is going to hold the Royal Champion up. Also hold the Diggy up there, obviously. Royal Champion's going to go down, not getting too much value. And here comes that Lalo from the bottom of the base. Going to try to push it into the Town Hall area. And he should be able to get it in there with all of his spells still. Free spell goes down early. Balloons are falling. They're going all over the place here, guys. This could be devastating. Sweeper's pushing them back. Gonna have to use that Warden ability. Balloons are going around. This could be a one star for Van. Tornado. The balloons are trying to get this Town Hall. They can't get there. Go, go, go. Town Hall falls. Barely gets the two star. Wow, what a save for Van. Oh, baby. I thought it was a one star, guys. I thought it was a one star. That is crazy. It's going to be very low percentage. Like, that one loon just barely got that Town Hall down. That was insane. Super low on the percent here. We'll run it less than 60%. So still a really huge advantage for Clash Champs here. But that monolith, oh man, that monolith just took the queen down. And we were talking about it, the monolith's going to be getting a nerf soon. I mean, those are the situations you got to account for. Monolith just doesn't go down. 59% two-star to start off for Chasmac. pCastro's in, looking for the big response. Let's see what we get. Queen charge Lalo for pCastro. We got a Flame Flinger selected. I was looking where we might see that Flinger come in. There's Mortars protecting all through here. Okay, so Mortar's going to, or the Flinger, rather, is going to come in and try to get through the scatter and get through this top area. Remember that bow will target the Flame Flinger eventually. Here come the healers for the Queen Charge. Queen Charge will push that Flame Flinger right into that scatter shot. I think that's the main target. Let's see if he can get this queen to go all the way to the Town Hall. It looks like that could be the goal here. Enemy queen's targeting his queen. Headhunter comes in. There we go. Queen goes down. Flame Flinger's still working. His queen's going through town, or Clan Castle, excuse me. Pulled out partially. A partial pull. We got an Ice Golem. It looks like it's going to be a triple Ice Golem CC with five archers coming out and one Ice Golem. That means there's probably two more Ice Golems in right behind, which will just slow this queen up. It's not really going to be too much damage for her, but it's just going to slow her up a little bit as she makes her entry into this compartment. Flinger now walks onto that scatter shot, and we're just taking a look around here, guys. Just making sure we don't miss anything. There we go. Scattershot goes down. Queen is working. She's trying her hardest to get through these Ice Golems, reserving that poison spell. That bow right here is locked onto the queen, which means that scattershot will be able to get a little bit more damage through here. Lalo coming through early, so the queen is in charge of getting the Town Hall here. Queen has to get all the way to the Town Hall no matter what on this one, because he's going opposite of the Town Hall with his Lalo. Lalo's working, Queen's working. I'm just trying to keep an eye on everything. Gonna use the King to cut the Queen off. Here comes the Lava Hound working through with the balloons. We'll have Warden ability going off there. Single locks onto the Queen, but no big deal. But he pops the ability for the Queen. Just a lot of pressure on her. Rocket Loon's coming in with the Rider out of that Flame Flinger. We've got to get all the way over to this Town Hall. Town Hall's under pressure. Or the Queen's under pressure, the healers. King's going to try to get in here. Poison Spell goes down for all those skeletons. I'm a little bit concerned. Only a little bit. Still has Royal Champion. Royal Champion is in. King's there. Royal Champion will come over. It's three star. It's a three star. It's definitely a three star. It's a three star. Woo! pCastro's OP for a reason, guys. I would never have the courage to do that. Oh my goodness, pCastro's OP. I would never have the courage to do that. Oh my goodness. Nice attack, pCastro. The Phoenix holding on there, helping that King get through the Town Hall. Man, you gotta have courage to do that, and it's a three-star to start off for Clash Champs, taking that lead. Woo, the guts on pCastro. Max is in next. Chasmac needs a response here after that big miss from Van to start us off. I mean, they still got the two-star, so they're not out of it, but with Clash Champs getting the triple, a lot of pressure on. We got 14 Sneaky Goblins, which usually means the Town Hall is going to be targeted with those Sneakies. Looks like Skelly Donut coming in. Skelly Bat Donut coming in. CC trying to get the Monolith. We'll see if we can get through here. Oh, he makes the Monolith invisible again. CC does go down, but he's not going to get the Monolith as all those skeletons and bats are fading out. So not as much value as Max was hoping for here. Trying to work in, trying to get to the Town Hall with the Sneakies. Plenty of Sneakies. Town Hall should be secured, no problem. That's one way to work around it. Just throw in the Sneakies, invis those Sneakies, and secure the Town Hall. Max will get that Town Hall down, securing the first star. Second star will come at 50% since the Town Hall is already destroyed. Going with a Skeleton Spell here just to protect those heroes a little bit. That Queen will be distracted on there. Did the King get targeted by the Scattershot already? It looks like it. Royal Champion's going to accompany these heroes in from this left-hand side. Going to try to get as much value as possible. I was really hoping that Monolith would be down to take some of the pressure off the heroes and allow them to get a little bit further in there. But unfortunately, with that Monolith staying up, it's going to make this hero charge just a little bit more difficult. Stone Slammer comes in from the top side. Multi-target Inferno is going to go down. And here comes the Lalo from the top. Scattershot's going, or Stone Slammer, excuse me, going into that multi-target Inferno. Queen pops her ability. Lalo's coming through. No Warden. Warden's going to come in with the right side Lalo. Good freeze on the Scattershot to make sure those balloons get it down. Warden ability goes off. Headhunter's going to go ahead, take down that Royal Champion, but the Monolith needs to drop here. Dragon Rider finally gets the Monolith down. Still plenty of troops working around here. King getting targeted by the Headhunters, but a lot of base still remaining. This multi-target with this Tesla farm is going to be tough. Lots of traps going off here. We got cleanup all around the base. We secured the two-star early for Max. Let's see what we got. I don't think this gets there, guys. I don't think this gets through. Actually, I know this doesn't get through because all the balloons are dead for Max, but Max is going to look to run this up, hopefully up to 80%, and Chasmac is going to fall behind a little bit more here. They really needed a three-star response, but we've seen in these wars, anything can happen. You get just a couple hot streaks in a row, and anything can happen here. This one will run up pretty decently, actually, up to, what, 85, 86? Should be with no problem. Warden will actually outrange the Teslas, so the Tesla's not a big deal. Oh, wait, he got just a little bit too close, but he's still fine. Still working through here. This has a chance to get to 90 with that bow being on ground. This should get really close to 90. Not quite a three-star, but it's a hit that keeps Chasmac alive. They still have to recover from that miss earlier, but they're still alive in this one. 89, I think they get to 90 here with the Warden finishing off this bow. Yep, there we go. Maybe even 91. Keep going, Warden. Keep going. Maybe even 92. Keep going, Warden. Keep going. All right, CMG Max going to get it up to 92% on the 2-star, but Clash Champs still in the lead with the 3-star and that 100%. They got to just get a good 2-star here to maintain that lead. And we're right back in with PATOLINO. Let's go, PATO. Let's go. ET Smash. Zap ET Smash. I think we're going to go after the Monolith with the Zap. Probably the Monolith of one of these Poison Towers, I would assume, with the Lightnings. Let's see. Warden's going to go ahead and set up the pathing here. Does have a blimp selected. Can we see the blimp go in for the Town Hall? Will we see that blimp in maybe one of the Scatter Hero compartments? We'll have to wait and see as this Warden's going to work through here. I wouldn't be surprised if we see like the Electro Titans go through the middle of the base here, jump to the Eagle Artillery, and then blimp for the Town Hall. Blimp actually switches to a Scatter Shot. Nice use of those balloons to pull out these Teslas. You don't want those Teslas throwing off your Scatter Shot here. Great use of those troops there to pull up the Tesla farm. Warden's still working here. Here comes the Zap and the Quakes. Oh! Just a little slow. The healer gets, or the battle builder gets there. Ugh, that could be a little bit of trouble. Flameflinger's still working. He can't pull the Warden too early here, or else that bow will lock onto the Flinger, and then the Flinger will go down. The Flinger has to get to the Town Hall. Now with that bow down, he should be able to pull the Warden out. Here we go. Warden's going to pull out with the Electro Titans. We got King with a couple Witches, Pekka up top. Also, King's going to accompany the Electro Titans with the Queen through here. It's going to be tough. As long as everything gets through the middle early enough, the Monolith should lock onto like the King and everything else. Ooh, a couple skeletons on the Flinger. I don't think he sees it. Oh no, that's bad. I don't think he sees it, guys. Uh-oh. He didn't see it. Skeletons take down the Flinger. He might have to send Royal Champion to save this town. Royal Champion's up top. Uh-oh. There's nothing at the Town Hall. There's literally nothing at the Town Hall right now. That's not good. Titans there. I guess we could use the Titan, maybe Rage? But, oh, I'm worried. Hold me, chat. Just hope it all loops around. Oh, no. Lots of pressure on this attack. All right, Queen's working here. We need the Queen to get healed up a little bit. She's going to take some pressure from that Scatter Shot. She forces out ability with that Mala there. Oh, man. Oh, no. This is a bold play. We still got Titans out in front of the Royal Champion. If they could tank for the Royal Champion, it would be great. Balloon coming in here. Diggy's going to stun the Scatter Shot. All right. Royal Champion still has ability. So if we can just keep the tanking in front here, which they're all gone. I think this is going to be a one star. Oh, no. I think this is going to be a one star. Oh, the devastation, man. The devastation. Oh, that's a huge defense for Lexnos. Exactly what they were hoping for. Gonna square this war all back up. Clash Champ should still be up on percent. He did not see those skeletons come out and just damage that flame flinger there. And it's a one star defense for Clash Champ, or for Chasmac. Clash Champs, oh, that's tough. So after the one star, 4-4, 37% to 30%. So Clash Champ's still up big on percent, but we're all square now. Matt is in for Chasmac, going up against Celino's base. Dragon Riders with Zap. Ooh, I think he's going to zap out the Eagle and the Monolith here, bringing 7. I mean, there's a lot of value in the middle of this base. Actually going to go for the multi and everything else around. Okay, I thought he could go for the Monolith there, but I guess with the Riders and the Balloons, the multi makes a lot of sense. Their middle multis could be tough. All right, working through here. Queen should go in and get the Town Hall. That's her job here. King's going to go in, take out the Scatter Shot and the enemy Queen. That's his job. And Royal Champion will just accompany and take some of the pressure off of these heroes by taking down some of these defenses. Queen's working through here. King's popping his ability. Here comes the Clan Castle troops. 3 Ice Golems with archers. Invisibility for the Town Hall. Town Hall is going to go ahead and be invisible to the Queen, but she's going to be fine here. Like, she should be able to get it no problem, especially with ability. Royal Champion's working through the Monolith. Royal Champion gets the Monolith down right before she gets taken out. Queen's ability is going to allow her to finish off that Town Hall, and then the Ice Golems are just kind of caught up here. We got the Dragon Riders coming in from that top side right in towards that enemy Royal Champion. Headhunters will go right in to take her down, and this is looking like a strong start for Matt. Remember, with that one-star defense, Chasmac could pull ahead here with a three-star if they could pull this off. Sweeper's pushing all the troops all around. That Stone Slammer is just looking really strong through there. Great freeze on the air defense with that Dragon Rider. Should be really nice there. Not too much pressure on, but the Stone Slammer will come through and sweep through this compartment. That multi could be a problem, but the Stone Slammer should just sweep through all this a little bit later here. Tesla's down at the bottom. Air defense getting taken out by that Dragon Rider on the far side. It's almost like surgical Dragon Riders here, guys. Just pushing them all throughout the base here and there. But they are falling pretty quickly. That multi on the back end is doing a lot of work. Seeking Airman goes off in the bloom. We got a couple riders remaining with the Tesla farm. I don't know if this gets there. It was looking really strong. But with that Warden pedestal still up, quite a few defenses with the Tesla farm. I don't think this one's going to quite get there. Another Seeking Airman goes off. All the riders are down. It was looking strong with this last compartment with the Teslas, the multi-target Inferno, and that Warden pedestal. 2 OP. Great use of the heroes there. The Royal Champion got that model down, no problem. So this one's going to leave the door back open for Clash Champs. Remember, they're already up on percent, so they got a little wiggle room here. But a strong attack in Clash Champs' next volley should put them ahead really nicely. This war could really, really... Oh, it could go either way here. 87% 2-star for Matt. That sweeper pushing everything away from that multi just too much. Leo is in next for Clash Champs, going up against Max. Let's see what he's got for us. Queen Charge Lalo looks pretty standard here. No zap, no like blizzard or anything like that. Just a standard Queen Charge. These bases are really, really tough, to be honest. I do not like facing these bases personally, but let's see what Leo can do. He's on a whole different level than I am. Queen's going to go ahead and start opposite side of the Town Hall. King's going to go ahead and here just cut off some of that pathing. Needs to rage up the Queen. Does just that. And going to try to push this Queen into this compartment with the Scattershot. King's going to go ahead and work through this enemy King and this Eagle Artillery compartment. Should be no big issue there. Queen will go ahead and work through here, get through that cannon, and then she'll have no problem getting into that scattershot. I don't think King's going to get through the Eagle, though. Too much pressure with all those skeletons. So King is not going to get the Eagle. Oh, wait, with the Phoenix. I keep forgetting about King with the Phoenix. It might get there. It might get there. Go, King. Go, go, go. And the Phoenix should finish it off. Eagle gets there. What do I know? Dude, the King Phoenix play is OP. We're seeing that more and more from these pros, and it is such a strong play. Electro Titan and an Ice Golem coming out of the Clan Castle. Poison Spell goes down. Queen doesn't have too much pressure on her, so she should be able to handle that. Man, that Phoenix play on the King, just OP right there. That was crazy. I did not think he was going to have a chance to get that down. All right, let's just keep an eye on the base here. Make sure we don't miss anything else. Is he going to try to push this Queen all the way to the Town Hall? It kind of feels that way, right? He's still got two more wall breakers, and Leo is good enough with his Queen Charge that he can make it happen. Sweeper's being a little bit of a nuisance. Here comes that Royal Champion in just to help out. Oh, Monolith! Oh! No, it happened again! The Monolith threw the Queen ability! Oh, no! Oh, no! Alright, stick with it, Leo. Let's see what he's got. Alright, the invisibility tower. Oh, it goes off. But that's alright. I don't think Town Hall is activated yet. Anyways, needs like a balloon or something to go off on it. Oh, man. Oh, no. Alright, there we go. Town Hall is activated. He's going to save the two. Clash Champs is in a fine spot here. Like, they're already up on percent, so this is okay. I mean, honestly, he's still strong. He's still working through here. Still got the freeze for the scattershot. Let's see what Leo can do here. He's still got a chance. It's Leo. He's got a chance at it. It's tough, but he's going to run this one up. I mean, Clash Champs should keep their lead. If the Queen gets all the way to the Town Hall, this is crushed for sure, guys. No doubt about it, this is crushed. But with that Queen going down with that Monolith, it's going to be a little bit of a tougher go. But that Balloon just soaked up two Seeking Air Mines, which is massive. Let's see, we got Balloons and Riders coming through here. The biggest issue is going to be the single target Inferno right here. We got everything collapsing into the center. Oh, Single's going to lock onto the Rider. Oh, man. But the Rider's going to tank through the Wizard Tower. It's going to be really high percentage. It's a miss, but it's really high percent. So Clash Champs will maintain their lead moving into the fourth attacks. 93% for Leo. If that Queen gets there, it's a 3-star, no doubt about it. But a great save. 93% on a miss is huge. Fourth attack for CMG is going to come in from Gabriel. They need a solid strike here. Queen Charge Lalo looks really like a standard composition here. We've seen a lot of Queen Charge Lalo, but we're also seeing that Monolith be a menace. Monolith menace? Menace Monolith? The Monolith could be a big issue on these attacks. LoOPzera on defense here. Gabriel taking his time. Remember, they have timed hits, so he's got to get in at a certain time. So maybe just finalize and make sure that blimp line is fine. All right. Oh, blimp's going to fall. Not sure if that's where he wanted it, but This should get decent value, but it, more importantly, it pulls out the clan castle. I don't think he was necessarily trying to get to the monolith there. I think he would have brought in some more tanking if he was trying to get all the way to the monolith, but hard to say. Queen's going to work through the Titan here with the baby dragon, not throwing those healers in, just doesn't want to risk getting any damage on the healers from that Electro Titan. Funneling, starting over here on the right-hand side, using a Sneaky Goblin, using a minion, and that Queen's going to charge all the way up in here. Skeleton spell goes off, but there's so much damage around that if that monolith locks onto the Queen, it's going to stay locked onto her. So this will be interesting to see once she steps up here. If there's too much to take down all those skeletons, monolith does not, or does lock onto, okay, there we go, monolith's locked onto the Queen, but she's able to target that monolith quick enough that she'll get it down quickly. All right, there we go, monolith is down, so no big drama from the monolith. It's tough, man. That monolith has been crazy so far. All right, let's see, trying to push the Queen back into the town hall perhaps. I think that would be the goal here, right? Push the Queen right up through there. He's got three wall breakers still. King's gonna go ahead and work through here. Kenneth with the $10 donation. Thank you, Kenneth, appreciate you, brother. King pops off ability. Royal Champion's working through here, working into that enemy Royal Champion. Queen's just taking her time at the bottom of the base. A minute 25, still plenty of time for a Lalo. I know it doesn't seem like a lot, but these Lalo attacks can move really quickly. Ooh, Wallbreaker doesn't quite go where he's hoping for, but the next one should. Headhunter gonna come in to assist his Queen, and the King actually gonna go all the way in towards the town hall. Oh, that's crazy. King gonna get a little bit of extra damage taken out. Queen should have no problem getting through this town hall compartment with her ability still. King gonna get just a little bit of damage there. Phoenix is in there working. Queen's gonna finally get through. At the 1 minute mark, we get the Lalo working through. This one's got a lot on the line. Lalo's pushing through, but there's not too much up here. If this Warden ability can be strong, like timed just perfectly, this could be a nice three star. It's a good start for Gabriel, but a lot of key defenses here at the top of the base. Rage spell goes off, raging up that Inferno, the Wizard Tower, even the bow there on the Queen. 29 seconds, still plenty of time to work through here. Balloons are clumping together a little bit, but Queen gets that splash damage down. I think this is going to be a three star for Chasmac. Gabriel, 18 seconds. Time's going to be the only thing that could hold him back here. 14 seconds. He's got all the defenses down. Well, let's see if he can get a balloon split here. 7 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh, he barely got it. Barely got that army camp down, and it's a three-star, and Chasmac take the lead. LoOPzera needs a response for Clash Champs. They're down by a star now. We got an Ice Lalo. Might even see a Skelly Donut here. There's a clone. There's four in Viz. Yeah, here comes the Skelly Donut onto the monolith, onto this the clan castle. He could have even got the multi-target Inferno with a bat spell if he really wanted, but really just wants to focus and get down those key spots that he wants. Mostly, okay, whew, gets through there, gets through the clan castle. I think he could have been fine without that last invis, to be honest. I know there was a lot of pressure there, but didn't want to risk it. Balloons coming through here. Remember, we don't have a queen charge on this one. This is more going to be a hero dive. And are we going to see the heroes try to go all the way for the town hall? It looks like with the pathing, no wall break, so I don't think the heroes are going to go. Actually, Queen could get there. If King goes up into this compartment to get the multi, Queen could path around. All right, Queen goes in there. That's perfect. He's using a few giants to tank. King's going to work through this compartment down here. Queen with the Royal Champion should be fine to get the town hall. Yeah, they're going to get it. I don't know why I even question it. It's not even close to not going for the town hall. Poison Tower launches there. He's got plenty of support here for the Queen. King with the Phoenix is going to go ahead and get out the multi. Phoenix soaks up a couple of Seeking Air Mines. Queen's ability going to go ahead and get through the Town Hall here. Uh-oh. Wait. Does not get through the Town Hall. Wait. Did I jinx that? Uh-oh. I didn't jinx that. Uh-oh. All right. Sticking with it, though. Just checking the pathing. Just checking where the targeting is going to be. And here comes the Stone Slammer in for the Town Hall. Stone Slammer should be able to... Oh, Seeking Air Mine. Whatever's in the Stone Slammer should be able to secure the Town Hall at minimum. But definitely not what LoOPzera is hoping for here. Freeze Spell goes off. Oh, man. These Ugh, these attacks just a little bit off there at the Town Hall. Warden's down at the bottom side. We do have the Lava Hound going through here. Headhunter is going to take out the enemy queen. Remember, the king got the enemy royal champion. Clones up balloons near that town hall compartment, but the poison tower goes off here. Not a lot of spell support remaining. Has to go into that sweeper. And this one's, oh, this is not looking great here for LoOPzera, unfortunately. Oh, no. Oh, no. I'm worried, guys. I'm worried. I think, like, ugh. Even if queen gets that town hall down, I mean, he'll have stone slammer. But that core was really tough here, and those sweepers pushing back were really rough, man. Oh, that's tough. 70%. They're still fine on percent if they can get a defense, I think. We'll take a look at it. But they're going to have to get a defense on their last attack. Remember, with Chasmac getting that 3-star, Chasmac is up now. So if Chasmac 3-stars on the final attack, they could just put the war away. But if Clash Champs gets the defense, they're going to need a 3-star at minimum, and then it could still be really close. Oh, a lot of pressure on here. Oh, that poor minion. That poor minion's about to get crushed. Actually, time runs out. Let's just see. I just want to see what the percentage is here. 75%. All right, so Clash Champs is still up on percent. They're still up on percent. So if they get a defense and then 3-star, they can win it. It's going to come down to Lexnos for Chasmac and CELINHO for Clash Champs. Let's see what they got for us, guys. And here we go, guys. If Lexnos can get the 3-star, he'll win this war, and then Chasmac will go on to face Tribe Gaming. If they get a defense, or if he gets a 2-star and Clash Champs gets a defense, Clash Champs will need a 3-star in their final attack. Looks like we got Lalo, but we do have invisibility spells, so we could see a Blizz Lalo here at the Town Hall, and I think that's what we're going to see, is a Blizzard Lalo going right for the Town Hall, going to push, oh! The blimp falls short. It's short, it's short. The blimp does not land near the Town Hall compartment. This could be devastating. He'll still be able to get some value here, but definitely not the value he was hoping for. The double seeking air mine taking that blimp right out of the sky. Oh! Lexnos gets baited. He tried to use the invisibility to push that hound across that area, but it did not work out. Here come the rocket loons and the lava hound down to the bottom of the base so the queen can deal with them. Lex definitely not going to panic here. He's been in this situation. He's fine. I love the Electro Titan play here just to help out with this lava hound. Once that lava hound pops, it's going to be pretty much instantly gone. Once they come in tight, yeah, look at that. All those pups getting taken out. Queen's going to be fine here, and now he'll have an Electro Titan to go ahead and accompany those heroes and try to save this town hall. But look, guys, the monolith is right there. The monolith is right there, and it's going to deal some massive, massive damage. But King's getting to the monolith. Skelly's pulling the King out. King's coming back. King's popping ability. All right, so heroes got to commit down to the town hall area. He uses the Warden ability, so adjusting the plan here, moving it over the town hall. He should eventually get this town hall down. Everything's just kind of slowed down there with that double poison going off, covering that whole area. Queen finally gets the town hall down. King's working through here. It looks like King might be popped. Yeah, there goes the Phoenix for the King. Lalo's going to work through the top side of this base, accompanying these heroes. Queen and Royal Champion still have ability, so there's still a lot left here for the heroes. But the Lalo faded quickly. That Queen just did so much work to the Lalo. And this could be the defense that Clash Champs needs. This could be the defense that Clash Champs needs, and it's looking that way, guys. Not too many balloons left for Lex. He's going to just try to run up as much percent as he wants, as he can. But that blimp falling short is going to be the defense that Clash Champs was hoping for. This is huge defense for PATOLINO, and it's going to come down to CELINHO's attack to win the war. CELINHO, if you 3-star, you win the war and move on to the lower bracket finals to replay against Tribe. Remember, we had that close war against Tribe just last week. It was a tie, came down to time. It was tie on star, tie on percent, came down to the time, and Tribe was just a little bit faster than Clash Champs. But we have to get the 3-star first. CELINHO's going to have to get the triple. It's triple and go on. Don't triple and you're out. Oh, so much pressure. Nice try to Lex, but unfortunately the blimp falling short cost him this attack. And it's going to be 77% for Lexnos. Comes down to the final attack of this war, guys. CELINHO is in for Clash Champs. It all comes down to this, guys. Let's see if he can get the victory. Queen charge Lalo for CELINHO. Let's see where he starts here. I'm not even going to try to predict it because I have no clue. All right, there we go. queen's gonna work from the top side. Stone or log launcher. Oh, this could be a log launcher charge, which means the king, queen, or queen, RC, and warden will come over here, and then that log launcher will come to push the queen further into the base. Okay, log launcher will be up top here. So queen will just wrap around this far side here. Okay, I don't mind it. Gotta keep an eye on that queen though, Celino. She's taking some pressure. Rage spell goes down. Log launcher getting spun in the tornado, but that's okay. Everything else is getting spun also. Warden ability goes off there. Log launcher finally pops through there. All right, working through to the middle of the base. King's working through that warden ability. Monolith goes down. Electro Titan's out of the clan castle. All right, Monolith finally goes down. I thought it was down earlier. First wall breaker comes in here. Oh! He just lost a couple healers. That's tough. Definitely can't be losing healers if he's trying to get all the way to the town hall here with the queen. Royal Champion's working on this far side, trying to get to the scatter shot. Enemy Royal Champion's going to come over. Oh! Enemy Royal Champion's going to distract. Enemy Royal Champion's going to be a problem. Oh! Royal Champion pops up with the Phoenix. Phoenix's going to get the scatter shot all the way down. Nice! Singles locked out to the queen. Queen's working through here. Oh my goodness, there's so much going on. Jump spells down. Queen's working. Invisibility tower goes off. No big deal there. Queen's working through here. He's got the single down. Queen will go ahead and work through with an invisibility. She should have no problem getting this town hall down. Celino needs a three-star for his squad. Healers being targeted by the air defense. Here we go, guys. Queen gets the town hall. The ground bows are no problem for the Lalo. Remember, no royal warden for the Lalo. I can't even talk. I'm so... this is nuts. I think he's got it, guys. This is looking crushed from Celino. Still got queen ability and clash traps. It's going to get the victory. What a war. What an attack from Celino. Time is good. Plenty of time. Over a minute. 8 balloons left. Celino crushes this base. Let's go. Clash Champ's going to get the victory. Move on to face Tribe Gaming in the lower bracket finals of the French Clash Cup. Winner of that matchup will go on to play the Queen Walkers in the grand finals. But what a war from these two squads. GG's all around. And Celino with a decisive strike for that three-star war result. Victory for Clash Champs. GG's all around.